Now let's take a look at atrial fibrillation. There are three primary types of atrial fibrillation. Transient AFib stops on its own and may last anywhere from seconds to minutes to hours and even up to a week. Then we have persistent atrial fibrillation, which is defined episodes which last more than a week or episodes that are only stopped by either pharmacological or electrical cardioversion. And lastly, there is long-standing persistent atrial fibrillation, which is a type of persistent AFib that lasts longer than 1 year. Formerly, it may have been called chronic or permanent atrial fibrillation. The nature of atrial fibrillation is where multiple electrical impulses are being generated in the atria and at the same time, and therefore cause chaotic myocardial responses. And they may diminish the preload and effectiveness of the cardiac contraction. This action may cause the development of microemboli due to the stagnant blood flow from the atria. And in some cases, this even leads to a rapid ventricular response secondary to a reentry problem. The electrical pattern will have no discernible P waves, but instead it shows a fibrillatory wave between each QRS complex. Now, because there's a lack of coordinated electrical impulses generated from the atria traveling through the AV node and to the ventricles, the result is usually an irregular ventricular response, which also occurs irregularly. So now let's take a look at the ECG for AFib. We look at the rhythm. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? And in this case, the rhythm is irregular. Next, we look at the rate. What is the rate? The rate is 80 beats per minute, but irregular. Is the rate normal, fast, or slow? Well, in this case, the rate is variable because it's irregular. Then we look at the P wave. Are they present? And no, the P waves are not present. Do they occur regularly? And we would have to say no because there are no P waves. Is there one P wave for each QRS complex? Again, the answer would be no. There is no P wave for each QRS complex. And of course, are the P waves smooth, rounded, and upright? No, only fibrillatory waves exist. And lastly, do all P waves have similar shapes? But again, in this case, no. So then we move to the PR interval. Is the PR interval normal, less than 0.20 seconds? No, because there isn't a PR interval. And then again, is the PR interval constant? But this doesn't apply because there isn't a P wave. So now we move on to the QRS. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? The answer is yes. The QRS is within normal range. And is the QRS wide or narrow? And in this case, the QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? Here, we can see that each one looks similar. So here is my cardiac interpretation based on this ECG. The ECG clearly shows that this patient has AFib. It's quite rare in children, but can occur in children with cardiomyopathy and after complex heart surgery, and very rarely in children with otherwise normal hearts. Expert consultation will be required to properly treat a child with atrial fibrillation.